Guror anugrahenaiva puman purna prasantaye. Guror anugrahenaiva puman purna prasantaye. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, Guru Kripa is above all. Guru Kripa is topmost backing for us. Guru Sussasanam Nama Sarva Dharma Tamattamam Tasmat Dharmat Paro Dharma Pavitram Dharma Navidyate. Guru Sussasanam Nama Sarva Dharma Tamattamam Tasmat Dharmat Paro Dharma Pavitram Dharma Navidyate. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, Guru Seva is above all. Guru Kripa is above all and Guru Seva is above all. Topmost backing for us. Srila Saraswati Thakur told, more or less we are all attached with some mayavad vichar. Srila Saraswati Thakur told, more or less all of us attached with some mayavad vichar. It's very, you know, typical thing, very important thing. Why Prabhupada is speaking this way, that we are all our heart contaminated with some, you know, more or less, little bit, mayavad vichar, contaminated. Why? Prabhupada speaking this way. It is true, that's why he is speaking. He don't care what you mean. But actually, Prabhupada want to say that we don't have 100% belief in Guru Vaishnava. You can search your mind and ask that you believe 100% Guru Vaishnava? You don't believe. You believe. Maybe 80%, maybe 90%, but 100% you don't believe. That's why you are not getting benefit. Big problem. Mayavad Bichar, what is the fundamental thing of Mayavad Bichar? Those who are Mayavadi, they don't believe that Gurudev is permanent, eternal. They don't believe. They think Gurudev, and we can accept Gurudev for a certain period, and after that we can leave. When you can realize Brahma, no need of Gurudev, we can throw Gurudev. This is the conception of Gurudev. And they don't believe that Krishna is a eternal sarup. They don't believe. They think sadho kanam hitarthayo brahma rupa kalpana. Mayavadi, they are speaking, Shankar speaking this way. Shankar speaking this way, sadho kanam hitarthayo brahma rupa kalpana. Actually, Brahma is no, you know, sarup is okay, is very fine. And if at all we can accept some vigraha, okay, no problem. But for sadhak, those who are doing bhajan, for certain period they can concentrate their mind on that vigraha, is vigraha. After that, when Brahma Bhava is satisfied, they can get, after that they can throw vigraha. No need actually. This way, Mayavadi never cannot believe that Krishna is an eternal feature, Guru Vaishnava eternal, as per Vaishnava Siddhanta, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, Bhakta, and Seva should be in same platform. If there is up down, then it's not possible. Suppose Krishna is, you know, transcendental plane, and he has material plane. You cannot expect that you can do seva 100% of Krishna. Not possible, there's gapping. You will have to make up that gapping, you will have to go up. Then you can ask, then why Guru Varga asking us to do seva, vigraha, this, that? Why? They don't know? Then no. To help you overcome this problem, this, you know, there is some difference to so that you can overcome this problem, they are giving you facility. Under pure Guru Vaishnav, when you are doing bhajan, somehow you are doing, because Gurudev asking, hey, go and get some flower, I am going to do archan. This way, by the instruction of Gurudev, you are going to get some tulsi, you are going to get some flower, you are going to market to buy something. Anyway, you are going there to deliver something, prasadam. This way, if you go on, if you go on doing this kind of seva under the guidance of pure devotee, Gurudev, then somehow, indirectly you are doing seva. Krishna, if you are going to offer flower and fruit, everything directly to Krishna, Krishna cannot give, because there is difference. But when you hand over these fruits and tulsi, flower to Gurudev, then Gurudev accept him. Then after that, Gurudev can sit for archan and Gurudev can offer to Krishna. This way, not directly, but indirectly, somehow you are doing seva. At all, if you are going to follow pure Guru Vaishnava, then this is the condition. But when you can overcome this problem, there is big difference, you see, then of course you will have to come through this Guru Seva. Because without Guru Vaishnava Seva, you cannot expect you can go up. It's the only procedure. Without Guru Vaishnava Seva, you cannot expect that you can go up to the level of Krishna and start doing direct seva to Krishna. It's a matter of joke, you see. Prabhupada speaking, in the temple, in your temple, you see, suppose there is Radha, Govinda, this, that, Vigraha is there, installed by your Gurudev. I know, installed by your Gurudev. But when you enter into the temple to worship, when you come out, Prabhupada asks him, you worship? Yes. Whom you worship? Radha, Govinda, Gaurani? Yes. Prabhupada, no. You are not. Yes, there is deity, Radha, Govinda, Gaurari, I am worshipping there. I was there inside temple. No. Maximum, you can go up to the level of, you know, Lakshmi Narayan. So long as your heart is contaminated with some desire, this, that, quite impossible, not possible. Somehow, if you go up to certain level, but still you have a conception of appliances. Krishna can save me, Krishna can do that, this, that. This kind of conception there. When you think this way, then Krishna is not at all satisfied. Why I speak this way? Because I want to discuss about the glories of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, my Gurudev. So why I like to discuss this point? So that you can change your conception. You can come online to understand this factor that without pure Guru Vaishnav, you cannot do actual bhajan. It's not possible. Now, first I started with this point, Guru Ranugrahen Naiva Puman Purna Prasantai. Actually, in 10th canto, Sudama Vipro and Krishna, when Sudama Vipro very young age, and Krishna, Balaram, they are going to Sandipani Muni house there, you know, they are taking lesson from Sandipani Muni. They like to say, 64 days it took, every day one full chapter, my course complete. 64 course, one day one course, here complete. Krishna and Balaram. That time they developed friendship with Sudama Vipra, is a very poor man. Poor in the sense, no money. Actually, poor if you think, Daridro, if you want to get the exact answer of Daridro, poor, then I would say this way. Which way? As Krishna answering to Uddhava. Uddhava asking to Krishna, Who is poor? Daridro jastu asantushto kripano tu ajitendriyaha. Those who have no control over their sense, they are kripan, mizar. You see, in this material world we think, if you don't like to spend money, then you are miser. Keep on. Close-fisted. You don't like to let money go from hands. But Krishna speaking this way. Daridro jastu asantushto. Who is daridro? Who is asantushto? Always dissatisfied. Suppose you have a lot of money, you are still dissatisfied. You are not doing bhajan. Because if you are not doing Krishna bhajan, there is no chance that someday you can become satisfied. Without bhajan is not possible. Satisfaction can come in your life when you are doing exact bhajan. Otherwise some sort of infighting can go. Guru Vaishnava can know everything. They like to solve problem. They like to solve this problem because they like to, you know, get outcome, very nice, you know. There should not be any crack in relation. Very nice relation should be there. So this way, you see, actually Sudama Vipro and Krishna discuss. There Krishna speaking that when you are getting full kripa of Gurudev, then you are satisfied. Guru Ranugrahna Pumana Purna Prasante. Purna Prasante is Sanskrit word. Pur prasanti means perfect peace, peaceful condition. And after, before that, pro, one pro in Sanskrit grammar, pro, para, apo, onu, prefix. If you use this word, then the gravity of word, when power of word, become, you know, more high. That's why, you know, guru anugrahena naiva pramana purna prasantai. Not santai. Santa means peaceful condition. Pro means prakishto. Mane perfect exam. 100% perfect. That's why pro this word it is written in Bhagavatam. Prashanti means, you know already when you are discussing Chaitanya Charitamrita, I know, I can expect that you know this point. Krishna bhakta niskama taip shanto. Only Krishna bhakta who has no desire inside heart, only he is peaceful. All other, they have some sort of desire. So they are not, you cannot expect they are peaceful. They are not peaceful. Always their heart is, you know, full of restless condition. Always their heart full of restless condition. Only Krishna bhakta, you can speak that Krishna bhakta is peaceful. Without Krishna bhakta, nobody is peaceful. Because Krishna bhakta, inside his heart there is no desire, nothing, no smell of desire. So that's why the full picture of Krishna is there. I mean Krishna sitting inside their heart. That's why they are peaceful. And all other people, they cannot become peaceful. Prakishto. So actually Krishna speaking this way. Guru Ranaigurhanyoga Purna Puman Purna Prasad. Puman Purna Prasad. It is only possible. Now Mayavadi Vichar, I told you, they don't believe that Gurudev is Nitya. They don't believe that the Sarupa of Krishna is Nitya. But very, you know, it's a matter of joking. They are doing Guru Puja very enthusiastic way, more than you. They are doing Guru Puja in such a way you can dance. They are doing Maharaj. They are doing Guru Puja so gorgeous way. Yes, they are doing Guru Puja in a big way. But still, their Guru Puja is not perfect. There is no reality. It's false. Because they don't believe. They are doing. It's one kind of acting, you see. This is one kind of acting. You are showing that you are doing Guru Puja. But you don't believe Gurudev is perfect, Gurudev is eternal. What Gurudev is speaking, if I follow, I can go up to that level. But nobody will. That's why Prabhupada, with, you know, Prabhupada, very sorry to speak out this point, we all, more or less, contaminated with mayavad vichar. Because we don't believe 100%. If you believe, then you will have to follow Gurudev 100%. But you don't follow. Somehow you like to attribute some personal conception of Gurudev. Ah, Gurudev speaking this way, Gurudev. You don't understand what Gurudev like to do. If you can satisfy pure Guru Vaishnava, then and only then you can start actual Guru Bhajan. Now I make background first. Now actually point is that Gurupad Padma Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, he was the total embodiment of Srinadapi. He used to speak, more often he used to speak, that Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is humbler than the blade of grass. He is so humble. How? Because really, after Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj gone from this material planet, he used to follow Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, non-different from Gurudev. In toto, no kind of acting was there. 100% he is following, his, you know, as if Gurudev, he is following. Under his guidance, he is hearing Katha, speaking Katha, going anywhere. Each and every fraction of second he is taking permission from Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. This way he is following his Gurudev, same. Because I told you Guru Tattva is Akhanda Tattva. So this way, in my whole life I never think that Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is my godbrother, I never speak. You never hear in my Harikatha or Bhavana Goswami Maharaj, never speak this way. I always speak, they are my Gurudev, Guru. Because they are Sikha Guru, I think this way. They are my Siksha Guru. I don't never think, he is speaking. You are my godbrother. No, I am not your godbrother. I am your Sisha. This way I am speaking. So I will have to speak something secrecy of the bhajan, about the bhajan of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Otherwise outside people cannot understand. This way, I like to speak something, some secrecy, actually. When Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj was, you know, there on this material planet, if I go on speaking one by one, how different way he was flowing his Gurudev 100%. Gurudev like to give this order to him, is carrying any order, 100%, any time. When actually when Maharaj came here in this bhajan line, I am speaking this way, but actually he is eternal parsad of Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj. But we are in this material planet, can think this way, he is coming. He completed his MA course, completed from Calcutta University. This way after that, he wanted to get some training, course of barrister. Barrister, you know, legal. Pleader, barrister, you know. He wanted to take. He started his course. But all on a sudden, he find in his, you know, village, he was going. Then he find in one house, top, there is some saffron cloth, red cloth. He entered the cloth. Some sadhu coming into your house? I think so. Red cloth? Yes, come. I like to take darshan. No, not now. You will have to come. Afternoon time, they can speak Harikatha. Now they are busy. Okay, I can come. Then he coming. After the entire room, there, where Maharaj was there sitting. When he look at Maharaj, he gone mad. How is that possible? What looking? Ajahnulumbi the Buja Madhava Goswami, look at her, he so nice sadhu and never see. Then at the same time he sell his heart. Then and there. That's why when actually we find, you know, in Rasamrita Sindhu, Adau Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam, you cannot believe this point. First of all, we accept Gurudev from heart. After that, we take Diksha. But with actors and just opposite. They don't know who is Gurudev, who is what. Hey, chop! You can go and take diksha from there. There is no man there to worship in our temple. You can't come. This way at present. Actually, what is written there in Hari Bhakti Ballabh, we are not at all ready to follow instruction. In Hari Bhakti Ballabh, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in his article, crying, is speaking, at present nobody like to pay attention to those instruction given by Rupa Goswami Pada there in Rasamrita Sindhu. About Guru-Shishya relation. What should be the relation of Guru-Shishya? How Shishya can approach, how Gurudev can understand his heart, and this way for long procedure, it will take long procedure to understand. Though it is not possible to understand Gurudev by a bondage of us, still he can watch. Because he can understand that Gurudev is doing 100% bhajan, 24 hours. Maybe he cannot measure estimation, but still somehow, if this Gurudev is bad character, some bad habit, he can at the same time, if he is staying with him, he can detect, then he can understand, no, he is bonded so, he is not Gurudev. If he is pure Gurudev, he cannot understand, but he can guess, it's nice. His Harikatha, like Srila, you know, Kunjo Vihari Vidyabhushan, Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. When Prabhupada was speaking Harikatha in Jogopitsa Mandir, Paramananda Prabhu, from same village, Kunjo Bihari Vidyabhushan and Paramananda Prabhu, the eternal servant of Prabhupada, from childhood, from 8-10 years, is doing seva of Prabhupada. They are from same village, Kunjoda and he. So somehow they discuss and he is speaking to Kunjoda, you are doing service, somehow you take permission from there for at least 1 month. You come here, then you join Harikatha, then you can understand. One day he is hearing Harikatha of Srila Prabhupada. After hearing Harikatha, he gone mad. Though eternal person is the Leela. How is that possible? He is speaking such a way, so that there is no sadhu, only he is sadhu. He is speaking such a way, he is speaking Harikatha in such a way, so that he is only sadhu, there is no sadhu. Because before he getting connection with some X mission, Y mission, they are all sadhu. After that, Kunjoda took decision, no, I am not going to stay here, hearing, I don't like to hear Harikatha. He took decision to leave Mayapur very shortly. Paramananda Vidyaratna could know his heart. He speaking, wait, man, wait. Don't take decision now. No, I like to go away. I understand his Harikatha. I cannot understand what he like to speak so hard. You hear Harikatha. It is my request to you. Don't go. You hear. Go on hearing. Because Harikatha is self-manifested. Forcefully you cannot understand. By the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, you can understand Harikatha. If you want to understand the Harikatha of Prabhupada, what I am speaking, you will have to get the Kripa of Prabhupada. Otherwise you cannot understand. Big problem. So Paramananda Vidyaratna requesting, wait, don't take decision so quickly. Hear more and more. More. Wait. I know you cannot understand. They went on hearing Harikatha divide. After hearing, after 10-15 days, he called, oh, Eureka, Eureka. This is actually exact Harikatha. I thought I took him wrong way, but now I see his actual Harikatha. Absolute truth. He is touching my heart now. But at first I couldn't understand what he meant to say, but by now I understand what is the gravity of his Harikatha. So nice. And he took decision, well, I can again come and take Harinam Diksha from Prabhupada, and then after that he is doing service for long whole life. He is doing. It was Kunjada, who was the first man to take Prabhupada forcefully. You will have to go to Calcutta. Why you come in this material planet? You are so great sadhu, you will have to go to Calcutta. No, I can. No, you will have to go to deliver all fallen souls. This way. In Calcutta, Ultradingi Junction, he took on rent, they got one room. That is the first, you know, mission started there, rented room. And Kunjoda used to cook very early in the morning. After cooking, he offered to deity and give the prasadam to Bhobab. After that, he used to go to office, GPO, General Post Office in Dalhousie. This way doing seva. So, you have to wait. This way, see, but here I told one point, you see, from Rasamrita Sindhu, Ado Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. But you cannot believe. First of all, when you see one sadhu, then you feel that I should sell myself onto his lotus feet. He is so great personality. I feel a great attraction. After that you can take decision and approach Gurudev. Gurudev, can you deliver me? I'd like to take Harinam Diksha from you. This way, on and on, gradually you will have to go and hear Harikatha. My Gurudev also. He used to do service in Port Trust. He used to come daily afternoon time and hear Harikatha after from office. He come and throw his bag and go. Ultradingi Junction. After hearing Harikatha, first he got magazine. They are eternal prasad, but this is Leela. From Kirtananda Prabhu, Gaudiya. He got Gaudiya Patrika. He heard about, my Guru Maharaj heard from childhood, heard about Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Prabhupada. Because Bhakti Ratnakar Thakur is disciple of, you know, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. And my Guru Maharaj's village was there, just near. His house. Their deity. Still their deity is there, Madan Mohan, in Goyaspur. In, you know, Kalyani, one stop is there. Still their deity. They used to, Guru Maharaj used to see, take darshan, you know, very nice. This way, Prabhupada, Guru Maharaj took information. So, Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, same way, as I told you in Rasamrita, Ado Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadish. First, you see your Gurudev and accept your Gurudev. This is my Gurudev. In my life also, when I see picture, this is my Gurudev. I accept it. After that I got Harinam and Diksha. This is the actual procedure. Like previous days, those king, they used to arrange, you know, open sabha, assembly, where a big king used to come, take part in that function, and if daughter, like to choose his husband, own husband. This is my husband. Sita Devi, you know, Draupadi, everybody, they took decision. This is my husband. This way. This is the procedure. And actually, Kardam Rishi also. Kardam Rishi, Devahuti. Devahuti is daughter of Manu Maharaj. But Devahuti heard, Devahuti Mataji, heard about Kardam Rishi's glories from Narad ji, then he sell her heart. I like to get him as my husband. How to get? Then after that, Manu Maharaj taking, wife and daughter in a plane. Plane mean Biman. I'm flying and go to Himalaya there. Where Kardam Rishi is. Actually not Himalaya, it was the Bindu Sarovar. They are going. After that, he, you know, in very appealing mood, humble mood. I pray to you, receiver, if you can accept my daughter, I think is, you know, it's just matching, I think so. Because he already sell her heart to you. what to do. In the meantime, Manu Maharaj already got information from Supreme Lord. Hey, that daughter coming, Manu Maharaj, his daughter coming, you must accept. Is just matching for you. This way. After that, accepting. So this is the procedure. So at present, if you can follow, if you try to follow this, you know, rules laid down in Rasamrita, is good. Bhaktivinoda is very much willing. One, everybody should follow. What to do? So this way, Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, at first sight, sell himself unto the lotus feet of Gurudev. He is my Gurudev. He is 100% my Gurudev. Now after that, he took decision. Because one godbrother, his name is, I forget his name actually, he was very, he was with Srila Maharaj, I mean, Bhaktivinoda Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Then when he meet him, he is giving argument. See, you complete your MA, now you like to take more education about your barrister. But when you become barrister, what problem you know? What problem? Actually, you have to sit in chair and hear about all criminal, you know, can come to you. He murder, he's doing this thing, you have to hear all rubbish thing. Oh, really? You can feel tension? Huh? Whole life you will have to feel tension. Really so? I cannot complete my course. If you can come with us, then you can enjoy your life. So nice, dancing, hearing Harikatha, so nice. Okay, I can come then. He took decision and come. After then, that time, Srila Bhaktivinoda Madhava Goswami was the acharya of Chaitanya Mahat. After Prabhupada gone, Srila Bhaktivinoda Madhava Goswami Maharaj was acharya of Chaitanya Mahat. After that some problem happened, then he leave that post and go away, no place to stay, this, that. At that time, his name was Krishna Ballabh Brahmachari. Who? Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Bharati Maharaj Narottam Brahmachari. Damodar Maharaj was there from Assam. Both of them from Assam, but Bharati Maharaj from Bakura. Damodar Maharaj is there and another from Assam is there. Then in Calcutta he is staying there. Old man there. First they came. Then after they started, there is no place where to stay. They don't allow them to stay in Chaitanya Mahat. Why? What problem? What wrong we have done? Anyway, they don't like. Then Maharaj speaking, Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj speaking, I never wanted to become Acharya. You all took decision to make me Acharya. Now you speaking, go away. Where to go? I don't know. We don't know. Go. And he took shelter in a shop in Calcutta, Hajra and Baliganj. In a shop, no place. Nothing, no money to manage themselves. You see, if you are put into this kind of problem, then you can prove that you believe Krishna 100% or not. That's why in the life of one pure Vaishnava, you have so many problems. In the life of one pure Vaishnava, you can find they are full of problems. They like to kill, they like to drive them away. For Pratishtha, they are fighting. But they are feeling no disturbance. In the life of a pure Vaishnava, always you can be full of problems and danger. Because otherwise, you cannot prove that you believe Krishna 100%. If there is so many problems, so many examination, test. If you are passing every test, Krishna sending you one test, first test, second test, third test. If you pass, then Krishna is salute. Nay, I can accept you. But you are not ready to appear and test. Huh? You like to jump and go to Golok and become gopi. It's a big problem. Well, there is no such procedure I never heard. Huh? It's not good actually. This way you have to do seva perfect. Then after that they started preaching. In the meantime, Maharaj was highly educated, MA. So any official job, anything, Maharaj Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha, I mean Krishna Ballabh Brahmachari, acting as secretary of his Gurudev. He is educated, very sober personality, no grievance, no prasadam, no clothes, nothing. There is no place to stay. He like to take shelter in a, you know, just staircase. Down there is one space, you know. Any staircase, you find some space down. He like to stay there. I'm here, nice. No, he need no room, nothing, no clothes. Clothes already torn. Gurudev speaking, your clothes torn. Well, really? He don't know. His own clothes, dirty, he cannot understand. He is doing seva all day and night. Eh? You should take prasadam on time. But no time, doing seva and seva. Gurudev giving instruction, hey, go with prasadam to his room, he is doing seva. Otherwise, he can forget taking prasadam. Then some devotee going there and entering the room of Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Maharaj. Maharaj, your prasadam. Okay. After he come back, and Madhav Goswami asking, he is taking prasadam? No. You just told, you bring prasadam, you feel. No! You go. Enter the room, he can forget. He go and arrange his prasadam directly after they inform me. He took prasadam or not. This year, he is always, you know, forgetting everything. Only Guru Seva he can remember. Every time. One day one thing happens, very important official job, Calcutta, Dalhousie, you will have to go. So Gurudev giving instruction 9 o'clock, all papers ready, and he is going to start at 11:30, he is prepared to go. In the meantime, some senior devotee, hey, where are you going, Krishna Ballabh? I am going to office, Gurudev speaking, with papers. Half an hour you can wait, prasadam can be ready. You can take prasadam, after that go. It is good, because when you can come back, there's no security. Well, as you are speaking, you're waiting. Madhav Goswami is coming now. Krishna Ballabh, you don't go, you are waiting. He forgot. I told you to go now. Oh, sorry, sir. He ran away. This way is doing seva. Never, no complaint. In the whole life of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, you cannot find even a single problem, complaint. How to detect that he is a big sadhu? This is a unique point. If you find there is no complaint with that sadhu, then be sure he is great sadhu. A pure sadhu cannot have any complaint against anybody. Maybe he is facing so many problems. Okay, turn back. It is a testing by Krishna. Testing by Krishna. This way, every time he is doing seva everywhere. I already compiled one book, you know, In Search of a Pure Pilgrimage. English not compiled, Bengali and Hindi done. His life history, very small. Because nobody giving any information, no diary, nothing. Only by his Kripa. I collected some information, right? Very nice book. There I wrote one point, you see, in Assam, when first preaching started, Sharbu. There actually, Parampuja Madhav Goswami Maharaj, actually, not Sarbuk, some other place. Sarbuk done by Prabhupada, actually. Other place. Assam, some place. I forget that place. I forget the name of that place. There actually preaching started. And Krishna Ballabh Brahmachari doing seva there. But water problem, very big water problem. One well, kuwa. From there we have to carry, you know, to take out. So that also, there is very big queue. Be careful when there is no problem, no fighting, you can go and take water for deities. Otherwise, some people can fight with you. That's why Maharaj going there to take water. But somehow, when he is taking water out, somehow some water, you know, drop into the pot of one lady. He is very dangerous ladies. Then he started, you know, fighting with Maharaj. After that, Maharaj fighting. He is speaking all rubbish against Maharaj. And Maharaj with what are coming? And Bhakti Dada Madhava says, what problem? Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari? No. Nothing. Going inside. She is speaking all rubbish against. He is so pure Brahmachari, speaking all rubbish. When Gurudev asking, no, Gurudev, nothing. Never do any complaint. Within short time, that Grihastha gone from that place. Krishna kick. Whole life, gone. This way, you see, Maharaj doing seva whole day and night, you see. And legal some, ideas there, because he started reading, taking course on, barristership. So any legal problem, anything Maharaj used to give instruction, you like to go to here, there, anywhere, and manage. And with preaching, for preaching, Maharaj used to take Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari with him, because very active. And sometime he is sending Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari separately. Now you can go separately. I like to see. This way I heard from many devotees that we saw Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari, then we take decision to come to Chaitanya Gaudiya. Like Rishikesh Maharaj was the secretary of finance minister. Rishikesh Maharaj now gone. He was in charge of Calcutta Chaitanya Gaudiya in Writers Building. He used to do service. He was the secretary of finance minister. I never saw my Gurudev before. When in Barakpur, when Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari, this Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha, when we heard Harikatha, then I feel some sort of attraction. Oh, so nice sadhu. Then I approach. I like to talk with you. I like to get some information. Yeah, you can come to our Gurudev. So many devotees told. Before we never see Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha, Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami. We see only Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Then we feel power. Fire coming. Only that day I was speaking in Ramnavami Tithi. I was speaking Harikatha there in Dauji Mandir. Your one godbrother from Austria. He is speaking, Maharaj, I was not sadhu at all. When Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami went there in Austria, then one devotee told me, some sadhu coming, you come. Then I saw. After that I hear some Harikatha. I cannot understand what he mean to say. After this started Kirtan. When Kirtan started, it was Nisinga Chaudhuri's day. Ito Nisinga, Paratha Nisinga. When starting Kirtan, he said, I feel shy. I feel afraid. I am going, to hide myself. Backside pillar. So powerful Kirtan. And red eyes, you see, like Nisinga appear. Then I feel, oh, this powerful sadhu, his Kirtan is so powerful. Then I feel attraction. So before I never saw my Gurudev, Bhakti Ballabh Puri Goswami Maharaj. First I feel reaction when I saw Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. After that, my Gurudev gone there, went there. So Sadhu Sangha I started. Then I could feel what is called Sadhu Sangha. Then and there, direct film came into my life. Oh! So powerful Kirtan, we jump up. Kirtan is big Kirtan, Hare Bam. This way so powerful Kirtan. In whole life, I also speak. I was really enthusiastic Kirtan Maharaj doing. Previously, we used to follow Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Because my Guru Maharaj is an old legend, don't like to go. Old age. Then he gives to give instruction, you go with Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami, do parikram. You can feel what you mean. Parikram, you can understand. Then I used to go. Brajamandal parikram, Gaurma, first I did Gaurmandal Parikram. But my Guru Maharaj, hey, jo, I do Parikram. And Maharaj developed loving relation with me. You know, I am the disciple of Bhakti Ballabh, Bhakti Ballabh Puri Goswami. And naturally, by that time, Maharaj developed some relation with me. I don't know why. By the mercy of my Guru Maharaj, maybe. So I used to do my editing job, and that time I used to stay in Calcutta Mutt, because it's very easy, because printing press is there in Calcutta, and Satish Mukherjee is very nice place. I used to stay there, take prasadam, and doing editing job. And Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami used to give me seva. And when I was Bombuchari also, red cloth, that time, used to speak to Rishikesh Maharaj, Samal Krishna is there? You can call Samal Krishna to me. You can call Samal Krishna to me. I like to talk with me, him something. After that, actually, you see, Maharaj used to give some seva to me, different kind of seva, very nice seva. Very nice seva. Sometime Maharaj speaking, you will have to edit this book, you will have to go there to complete this seva. You will have to do this seva. This way Maharaj giving instruction to me all the time. Sometime Maharaj speaking, by the mercy of your Guru Maharaj, by the instruction of your Guru Maharaj, I started foreign preaching, you know, I know already. Maharaj is not at all ready to go to foreign country. I am fallen soul. If I go, I can fall down. No, you will have to go. You are great sadhu. You have to go. My Guru Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, those foreign people, you will have to deliver them. You should not speak this way. Oh, you are giving instruction, then I will have to go. He is going to foreign country. Maharaj, if I die there, yeah, I am fallen soul. No, you will have to go. You are not fallen soul. Then Maharaj started doing. Even Narayan Goswami Maharaj also writing letter first to my Guru Maharaj. After that he going, and from America he used to write big letter. I used to read this letter and speak to Guru Maharaj. Big letter. And situation there, what happening, you know, preaching, different kind of problem, this, them begging Kripa from my Guru Maharaj. I read personally the letter, come, big letter. So many things. This way, actually. So Maharaj actually started following him. And after that, Maharaj giving to him, Samal Krishna, you have time? Maharaj, you speak, what seva you have? If you have time, no, I have time for you all the time. You have to go to airport, some foreign devotee coming, you will have to receive. Can you do? Yes, Maharaj, 100% I can do. Then I'm going there. And I get one car, and in car, half mold. When new devotee from Bhakti, never take diksha, nothing. New, nothing. Even with girlfriend coming. I don't care. I am sitting with driver, actually. It is the instruction of Bhakti Ballabh. So when driving, driver, I am speaking continuously Hari Katha to them. So in the way, half molding done, up to Mayapur. In the time of Gaur Purnima, if some foreign devotee coming, from airport I am going straightway, when driving, directly to Mayapur. So I have enough time, 3 hours or 4 hours, in which I am speaking Harikatha continuously, half mold. I am giving the glories of Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha. Maharaj is very happy with me. Sometime I come, evening time, Maharaj sitting in Sabha. When Maharaj looking me, done, I am coming already. This way Maharaj giving me seva all the time. Very, very nice seva. Actually, in whole life, Maharaj was so sober personality, you cannot find any kind of false ego inside him. No! He is big acharya. He never think I am big acharya. He never think. When acharya post was given to him by Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, I say, Maharaj, no, I am not fit for this post. Actually, Bharti Maharaj, you can. But Maharaj make him acharya. Because Maharaj knowing that if I give this responsibility, then actually it is I, you see. Maharaj can help after then in future. Because whole life, Srila, you know, our what? Bhakti Vigyan Bharti Maharaj, whole life, secretary. Whole life he was the secretary. Because no, Maharaj knowing, he Maharaj can understand his, you know, gravity. So in future, he can become Acharya this way. He planned to make. This way actually, Gurudev making him Acharya. Maharaj never want to take the post of Acharya. He gone to, you know, Vrindavan, in a very solitary place there in Govindakunda. Nobody find where Maharaj gone. Where Maharaj gone? Nobody knows. After that search. Then one big panda. Big panda. He is the father of Giridhari Panda. Giridhari Panda. He is staying in Govardhan. His father. He search out and find that he is there in Govindakunda. Then he is running there. Maharaj, you will have to go to Calcutta. No, you will have to go. If you don't go, I can kill myself. Ah, you kill yourself? You will have to go now. Forcefully catch him, very powerful panda. Very powerful panda. Come in Calcutta. Then all, you know, big meeting. There was paper written by Srila Bhakti with Madhava Goswami Maharaj. And the pleader came, Ukil, big. He keep documents, yes, the Maharaj making him next Acharya, so this way. But first when Maharaj came, and took Harinam and Diksha from Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, first seva to test, he has any false ego or not. To test him, Maharaj first sent, that time Madhava Goswami Maharaj was the Acharya of Chaitanya Math. He is sending Krishna Ballabh Brahmachari to Suvarna Vihar. Forest, that time forest. Nobody want to go there. Only one Gaur Vigraha is there. No, devotee cannot stay, no place. Snake and jackal everywhere. No facility. What to cook, when to cook, how to offer, how to stay. Mosquito and mosquito, all jackal night time. And no cooking arrangement. No cooking arrangement. Today you don't like to cook. So much facility in your kitchen, so much grinder, this, that, you know, cooker, gas. But still you don't like to cook. I don't like to. At that time I also cook in wood. I used to cook in my temple, forcefully. I must cook. It is the seva of Radharani. They don't allow me to cook. I must cook. Not that I can speak Harikatha. I must cook also. And nobody can see that what I am cooking. Like Jagannath temple. Outside people cannot know that today is Chana Rasa. Nobody can know. I can close kitchen. So evolution came with me. Hey, Maharaj is so tough. He don't allow us to enter. No. While cooking going on, nobody can enter. Big evolution going on. Kitchen room closed. Inside kitchen done. Cooking done. After that, with cupboard up, then boga can go. Like Jagannath temple. Everybody become angry with me. You can become angry. No, I don't care. This way, pure. Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami, Krishna Ballabh Brahmachari, no cooking arrangement. Only banana tree, you know, a screen of banana tree drying up. Then after that, he is making one, you know, with brick, making one oven. With brick, temporary. After that, the screen, dried screen of banana, baking, and giving fire with kerosene. If you don't give this full air, then again you will have to light again. No fire gone. This way, so high educated man, he is not habituated to do this kind of seva. Gurudev, hey, you must go. Let me see, you have vanity, you have false ego or not. He can say, I am MA pass. I am actually, I started reading barrister. Maharaj speaking to forest. Never think it. Never think this way. Actually, this point I was discussing in Chaitanya Gauriyamat there, Vrindavan, just a few days ago. I started with this point, Acharya cannot be elected through election. Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami speaking, you cannot elect an Acharya through election. Acharya self-manifested. You cannot elect Acharya. Only Gurudev can see he is Acharya. Many times I told you, Siddhanta, who is Satsisha? Who is Satsisha? He is Guru. Satsisha means he is Guru. So only Gurudev can see that he is Guru. By election, through election, Acharya can, you cannot elect an Acharya through election. Not possible. Some 15 years back, one problem happened in some place, in some dham. One old Acharya is aged enough. All disciples approaching Gurudev. One day, Gurudev, you are discovering Asustha Leela. Your age is enough. So if you can make one Acharya for future, if you cannot make an Acharya for future, then whom to follow? Yeah, this your society can break down. Gurudev looking at disciple, what? By the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I make this society. By the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I make this society. So if you don't make any Acharya for future, what problem, big problem, then this society can collapse, break down, then Maharaswi. I don't find anybody who is just fit for this post. Maharaj speaking, I don't find anybody who is just fit for this post. What to do? Then those, you know, disciples, they are speaking, then your society can break down, fall down, collapse. Well, by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am making this society. By the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if this society break down, it's still okay. I approve it. No problem. Still, I cannot make anybody Acharya. Because I don't find anybody eligible. I don't find anybody eligible for this post. So strict. Who is that Acharya I don't like to name? So strict. This way, you see, through election, he was not made Acharya. Already he was Acharya through Guru Seva. Through Guru Seva, he was also, through Guru Seva, continuous Guru Seva. Non-stop Guru Seva. He was already in the post of Acharya. Only Madhava Goswami could see his Acharya. Not that through election Maharaj make Acharya. So whole life Maharaj doing Seva this way. He say, when doing, after Madhava Goswami Maharaj gone, then Maharaj when doing Parikram, this, that, always under the guidance of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha. Anywhere going, Maharaj, you must speak Harikatha. Sitting, speaking Harikatha. Maharaj translating or doing something. This way. In Brajamandal Parikrama, sometimes they cannot maintain time. Because heavy schedule, they cannot maintain time. It's not possible sometimes going here, there. Some problem. Then some devotee become busy and restless and speaking in front of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha. It is due to Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, we are always late. He is old man, that's why you are always late. We cannot go fast, take prasadam, quickly take rest. Maharaj become fire like Nishingadev. Go! You go! Take prasadam quickly, go! I can follow Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Because I cannot see them. When he is going, with stick, very slowly, looking everywhere, Krishna Lila spot. He is describing, I can understand what is Dham, the glories of... So you can go. I don't care. I like to follow him. Go! Naik Nisringadev, go! Quickly you go. Take prasadam. You are late already. You should take prasadam on time. Go! I can go with Maharaj. This is a big, very strict, whole life. His character was so high. We, all of us should follow him. All of us should follow. What a nice, you know. Many times it happens so. In foreign country, Maharaj going to Russia, there in one hall Maharaj sitting, inside the room, Harikatha over, some devotee like to meet him. So somehow one devotee, two devotees, some that they are coming inside the room. One lady coming inside this room. He don't know how to pay Dandavat to Maharaj, how to honor sadhu. He don't know who is sadhu. They are from some Russia, you see, looking at Maharaj. After looking, he started crying. Crying, weeping, very high, you know. After that, when he see coming out, somebody asking, why you are crying? They are inside the room of Maharaj. Maharaj speaking anything, nothing speaking. But I don't know. When I entered the room of Maharaj, when I look at Maharaj, I started crying. I bursted into tears. What is the reason? I don't know. I feel some reaction in my heart. Mother of Kamalaksha, this happened. Many times happened. So. In some European country, some lady, half naked, just enter inside the room of Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami. Or else nobody, everybody busy with seva. Somehow he enter to see sadhu, who is sadhu. We never heard who is sadhu. He entered and looking at Maharaj. And Maharaj like child looking at that Mataji. Laughing. He become very shy. Looking at eye. No, he feels some reaction. Then she like to hide herself. When he come upside, see, I don't know. When I come, usually I'm habituated with this dress, this, that. But when I enter the room, I look at Maharaj, I feel some, you know, very so nice feeling, pure feeling. So automatically some feeling coming, I should not come in front of Maharaj this way. Very polite way, we will sit down. This way, Maharaj is so powerful, I cannot describe. So powerful. After Guru Maharaj gone, in Gokul, when Maharaj came inside, first gari from car, Maharaj dropped, coming inside room, nobody there, somebody, doing aarti, I am standing, I bursted into tears. He also loved me. I don't know why. This way we have Manarishnirudha. Anyway, this way you see whole life Maharaj doing this kind of seva. Whole life. Sometime, you know, going with Srila Bhakti Gurudev, with Gurudev, going to Punjab preaching, there also. And somewhere here, there Maharaj going. In Amritsar, there is a first Gaudiya preaching in Amritsar started. Bhakti Vita Madhava Goswami Maharaj going with some devotee. And there, Maharaj in that temple I saw, when I went to Amritsar I saw that temple. As on, not Gaudiya temple, different. Another temple. There. Maharaj used to stay and doing kirtan. Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami also with Gurudev. Madhava Goswami doing kirtan. When doing kirtan, all Punjabi people all around, thousands of people coming and watching the dance of Srila Bhakti Madhava Goswami Maharaj and Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami. They do not, they never heard, they never see this kind of kirtan and dancing. Madhava Goswami long, Hari Bol is so long. Then Punjabi people, they stunned. We never hear this kind of kirtan. We feel reaction. Next day, they are coming again to temple and asking to Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami, again today this kind of dancing, kirtan? Then Gurudev, then Tirtha Goswami is going inside the room of Gurudev, paying dandavat, very humble way, Gurudev. Those devotees, they have people coming, they are asking, today also this kind of kirtan, nice. Madhava Goswami not giving any answer, looking at Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami, he become frightened. Gurudev is so heavy, don't answer. He don't like to give answer. He come outside, become very frightened. Gurudev is so heavy. Today also this kind of kirtan, only this point is so. Gurudev is so heavy. Don't answer, they come out. This way preaching going on. Whole life. In Punjab, here, there, everywhere you can find. Now all mayavadi spot. Preaching down. Everybody. Because one pure Vaishnava, automatically everybody can feel some sort of attraction for pure Vaishnava. Because Krishna is there. Krishna is all attractive. Why? Pure, those, any people coming in front of a pure devotee, they feel reaction. Why? Because Krishna is sitting inside. Krishna is all attractive. That's why he feels, Maharaj is so high, Maharaj is so sweet. This way doing, preaching. So after that, you know, among devotees some problem happened. They like to put Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami always in trouble. Some false allegations, some false protest, always fire going on all around Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami. But still he is like Prahlad Maharaj, feeling very nicely. No complaint. Godmother! He is doing, going against case. He is fighting going on. Maharaj never, no complaint. No complaint. Krishnanagar Damodar Maharaj, in front of, you know, Acharya, I mean Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami, and chiding him so heavily, doing this way, that way, Maharaj swinging his ear, don't giving any answer, he is my senior godbrother. Don't give any protest, why you are speaking this way, what wrong I have done, never speak. He is my senior godbrother, maybe Gurudev make me Acharya. So he finds some fault with me, that's why he's chiding. Damodar Maharaj is chiding him, big way, in front of. But don't, never protest. Never! Humble. This way my Guru Maharaj used to say, he is, you know, example of Trinadapi. Up to last moment, he carry out his duty. Carriers duty. So soft heart. Any devotee doing any wrong activities, somebody complained, Maharaj, you must throw him out of mud. Maharaj saying, how I can throw him out? He is actually sick. He come to Gaudiya hospital. We are there to give treatment to him. How I can throw him? If I throw him, then he can get lost. Many times it happens so. Many times it happens so. In Vrindavan, some mayavadis, they are out of jealousy, say enter Chaitanya Gauriamat there in Gokul. Gokul Mahavan. They are coming with hacksaw and you know axe. And enter into temple and break deities. Deities. After that, all in Delhi, everywhere, minister levels, all information going on. Everybody held one big meeting, who all are responsible for that? Out of jealousy, they break. Big piece of land was there, they snatch that land from mud. Now they take control over that big field. Then after that, in the meeting, all devotees from Punjab, there they took the Gurudev You give permission. You give permission to us. We can do appropriate arrangement so that we can send them to jail. You just order us. We are waiting for your order. Within second, from Delhi force can come, we can arrange everything. You give permission. Maharaj, tears in eyes, saying, they are not responsible. Maybe I am responsible. For me, I am not doing bhajan properly. Maybe for this reason, this happened. Maharaj speaking this. Never say anything against him. This way, you see, everywhere. We have seen many devotees speaking all rubbish. Even Maharaj's Shevak, I don't like to speak his name. He is doing seva of Gurudev, speaking all rubbish against Maharaj. Go! You do your own seva. I don't like to do your seva. Go! You can do your seva. Maharaj looking at him, not speaking anything. Maharaj only looking at him. He is speaking all rubbish against Gurudev. After a few days, he developed big disease, dying. This way. Maharaj never, you know, go away from mort, never speak like that. This way, you see, after that, you know, so many nice devotees, they came to help Maharaj. So many devotees, computer seva, this, then medicine seva, last. I am very sorry to speak this point. At that time, Maharaj was very sick. Sometime he used to go take darshan of Maharaj. Sometime when I am going to Calcutta, take darshan of Maharaj. But that time, especially that time, I was in Vrindavan, Radhakund, speaking Harikatha daily at the bank of Radhakund. One place is there, Panda. That Panda came in Shiv Mandir. I am paying Dhanavad, prostrated. He respects me very much. He is Panda, small age. He is actually Gaudiya Sadhu. He took Diksha from, you know, our some Maharaj, Gaudiya Mat. So he respects him very much. In his big, you know, hall, I am speaking Harikatha. That day, I was speaking Harikatha. In course of Harikatha, I was just bursted into tears. I was bound to speak. Night time, Maharaj came. He is embracing me. I think Maharaj is not going to stay anymore. This much I told. And I started crying. I don't know why. After that, I came back here in Calcutta and in Mayapur. After 1 or 2 days, I put my luggage here, then go to Calcutta, because that time heavy. Maharaj was discovering heavy. You know, Asustha Leela. I went there. All Punjabi people, they know me. They hear Harikatha a long time. They are Punjabi here, there. They all come. I take darshan of Maharaj. After that, I sit for some time. I was thinking what to do. If Maharaj gone, then blackout. I was thinking this way. All Punjabi people coming around me, they were asking some point. After that, I came back with heavy heart. I was feeling, if Maharaj gone, then blackout. I don't find anybody here. Then after maybe 2 or 5 days, I ring to Prasad Prabhu. He knows. I was ringing Prasad from his phone. He ring Prasad and give the phone to me. What, Maharaj? Please try to give attention to my word. You ask that Maharaj to stop chanting mantra, Mrityunjaya mantra. Some Maharaj chanting. Stop. You ask him to stop. Because time already over, Maharaj like to go away. Be careful, don't stop Maharaj. Time is over, Maharaj like to go away. But due to Mrityunjaya mantra, he cannot go. We are giving pain to him. Ask him to stop fasting and Mrityunjaya mantra. I told you. Around 4 or 5 o'clock. You can ask him, he is sitting. After that, 9:30 or 10, information came to him, Maharaj gone. Afternoon time, 4 o'clock I told. And night time, almost 10. Information is one message. With crying, him send message, Maharaj, Gurudev gone. I get one message. Then after that ring came, he... So this way I think, though I am unfit, still Maharaj keeping me kipa. One day in Vrindavan, so many operations going on me, because I am speaking all about Prabhupada. Maharaj used to say, this is your mat. Your Gurudev used to stay here. You must do kirtan and press seva here. So stay there. Everybody putting me in operation, going on. All the time putting me in trouble. What to do? Then I wrote one strong letter to Maharaj. Somebody coming to Calcutta. Why they putting operation on me? Because I am speaking all about Prabhupada. That's why. They are not ready to hear anything about Prabhupada. They are always saying, Maharaj always criticizes everybody. I am not criticizing, I am speaking about Prabhupada. But they are putting me in trouble all the time, operation. I am not disturbed. I wrote one strong letter to Maharaj, maybe 16 years back, or more, 17 years. I wrote in this letter, Maharaj, be it sure 100%. I am going to get your 100% kipa. I am sitting in Vyasasan. I wrote this way. Maharaj, be sure, 100% I am going to give your kipa, full kipa. Nobody can get your kipa. I am going to get your kipa. I never think you are my godbrother. You are my Sikha Guru. Gurudev gone. You are giving me support. Loving me very much. One day Maharaj called inside his room in Calcutta. In Calcutta. There in Calcutta. Chaitanya Gaudiya. Inside room. Nobody was there. That time there was no such restriction. Maharaj used to stay. I opened door, Maharaj calling me. I paid on door and speaking in front of Maharaj. Maharaj, I like to give you a nice seva. You can take responsibility as the editor of our press. Your Guru Maharaj also used to do. I was laughing. My soul, Maharaj, one problem is there. What problem? Maharaj, I love you very much. But you know it's sure, 100%. My age is low. They cannot allow me to do seva, this seva freely. I like to do this seva. But be sure about it, they are not going to allow me to do seva freely. Always problem. Maharaj, look at me. Maharaj, no, it is true. It's true, 100%. If I take responsibility, then people can say he is doing this seva, he is doing wrong. Big problem. This way, Maharaj used to support me all the time. When I took base first, in Puri, Nilachal Khetra, the topmost rasa pit of Vipralamba, as per Bhaktivinoda Thakur. There, in Puri, Purushottam Dham, there Guru Maharaj is doing. Last time Guru Maharaj is doing bhajan. All the time, deep bhajan, always absorbing. From Mayapura wing, there, Guru Maharaj wants to give me base. After that, Guru Maharaj joking with me. So many joking Guru Maharaj making. You cannot expect such kind of joking with Shisha. He is joking with me. After that day, Rasa Purnima night time, I am in rooftop and Guru Maharaj in room. Morning time, whole night I am doing Harinam and I was thinking. And that time, there was a facility to look Jagannath temple, Sudarshan Chakra, clearly. Now so many hotel and congestion. By that time our roof was so tall, from rooftop we can see Jagannath temple. So I was doing Harinam whole night, Rasa Purnima night, and thinking what Guru Maharaj can give me base tomorrow. After that I come down in morning time after Arati paying Dhanabad, Guru Maharaj laughing at me, you can see I was whole night I was thinking about you. Why? You don't take rest? Oh, no. Why? I was thinking about your whole life, future life. Really? Guru Maharaj, I was looking about your future life. Really? After that, I take bath. After that I come, then Guru Maharaj give me base, alone, nobody else. Give me base, what is coping, what is the meaning, Gopi Bhav, everything Guru Maharaj speaking to me. I was laughing, I was sigh. After that, Guru Maharaj giving me seva, so nice seva, all the same seva. Guru Maharaj is to the Bani Seva, the special seva, which he got from my his Gurudev, Prabhupada. Then after that I come back, I come to Chaitanya Guru Mat. I come back to Chaitanya Guru Mat. So Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha, he was the first person with whom I meet after taking base. I was feeling very shy to enter his room. Rishikesh Maharaj catch me, come with me. Maharaj like to see you. He catch me and go inside. Maharaj, there was nobody. Only Rishikesh Maharaj and me. Maharaj look at me. Eh? Samal Krishna, white vest? He should take sannyas. Why? I say, Maharaj, I am unfit. You can do preaching. Maharaj speaking. He should take white. Why? White vest? He should take sannyas. Take this word. He should do preaching. Maharaj, I cannot do preaching. You can do preaching. I can stay behind you. You can stay with me all the time in preaching. But Maharaj knowing one problem is there. I cannot take prasadam. Because I have some special, you know, maintain something. Maharaj knowing this thing. But I know Maharaj cannot take prasadam. So Maharaj begin, they are cooking for me. You can take from there. So Maharaj speaking is big acharya. How I can go there like beggar? I cannot expect. But this way I used to manage. In Chandigarh, they are here. Sometime Bhakti Bhagavan Bharati Maharaj, his seva cooking. You have something? You can give to me. This way I used to save my life. Sometime Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha was this way. Because I cannot go there to take prasadam. There is no system. Big problem. Anyway. This way I lived to. Maharaj used to love me very much. After that, Maharaj used to give me seva. Continuous, some seva. After that, Maharaj's foreign preaching started, big way. So many devotees coming, coming and coming. Then, what to do? This way, actually. So, last time, Maharaj give me indication that I am going away. Otherwise, Maharaj cannot love me so much. That night came and embraced me, giving me so much, like child. And before also Maharaj coming in dream with a silver pot, paramanna, take paramanna, this way speaking, take prasadam, speaking, long way, long ago, not now. This way many times, Maharaj. And all other thing I cannot speak clearly, I should not speak, how I got kippa, come, this I can speak this way because you can kill some energy. All other secret thing I cannot speak. So all, you know, our Sikha Guru Varga, they all give me instruction. My Guru Maharaj, Gurudev, and all other Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Nila Giri Maharaj, Bhakti Vardham Sagar Maharaj, Satya Govindo Maharaj, you know, Nayanananda Prabhu, Prabhupada, Sabal Prasada Prabhupada. Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, everybody giving me instruction, Bona Baba giving me instruction. You should speak Harikatha. I don't know why. So I started. So this way I am going on speaking. I don't know. I can do any service for you or not. If you can expect, if you find any fault with me, you can give me a warning. I can check. This way, Jai Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj ki Jai! Nitya Lila Oshchavakti. Mancha Kalpaturusi Kipa Sindhu Bhavishya Patitanang Pavanu Bhavishna Bhyo Namo. So I'm going to Baleshwar tomorrow morning. So one point I like to say that they're all bonded soul or half bonded or 60% free, 40% bonded condition. They can have some kind of problem. It's naturally. Some kind of disturbance can be there, mutual disturbance. So you should make up this point. It is my request. If you want to get a havoc result in future, it is my request to you all. Some small problem you can ignore. And Srinadavi Sunich, bhav if we have, and how to respect other, if we know, then there cannot be any problem. My Guruma used to say, to respect even to child. My Gurumaj in room, in there, some child entering, Gurumaj before entering, the child only, 10 years, 12 years, he entering room. Gurumaj without any information, paying dandu. Somebody enter, even to child, ladies. I also, I respect to all Mataji, they are getting respect from me. Genuine respect. And I'm very happy that you are arranging this. This is so nice. Your etiquette is so nice. You are trying gradually. If you can, you know, mutual adjustment you can do, please, then gradually you can find a big result. It's major. We have to wait and suffer. Each and everybody should pay respect. They can love. Because already if you are doing bhajan, automatically love comes. For all creature. Even for dog, hey, you cannot develop enmity with anybody. Doinyo daya anne man, patishtha barjon. Chari gune guni hoi karaha kirtan. Bhakti mota giving away. Doinyo daya anne man, respect to others. Doinyo you know? Daya you know? Don't know? Doinyo daya. Daya means so mercy. Doinyo. Humbleness. Doinyo daya anne man. Pratishtha barjon. I don't care for my own pratishtha. So many people can speak this way. Sam Baba is, you know, pratishtha is speaking harikadi. I am laughing. He is speaking this way, okay? Yeah, he want to get big pratishtha, okay? I should not be angry. If I am angry, that means a weak point is there. Because it's the instruction of Prabhupada. If I put my veil here, like ladies, I enter into sanitary room, it's not good. It's coward. Prabhupada can say, you are coward. If I enter into room, huh? If I don't like to get pratishtha, and Prabhupada saying, Vaishnavi pratishtha you must take. Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami also do. Vaishnavi pratishtha tate karanishtha. Tahana karire rabibe rau me hell. You should be sent, you can be sent to hell if you are not giving respect to Vaishnavi Patishtha. So they can call this way. Sam Baba is waiting for Patishtha, big is speaking English. No, Babaji is speaking this way, okay? They can speak. So what, it concern to me? I'm laughing. Eh? They can speak this way. He is Paramahansa based, he is speaking this way, like Sannyasi, this way. They can speak this way. I don't care. I want to pay attention to Prabhupada. What Prabhupada told, that I like to do. They can speak anything they like. I don't care. Gradually, you should do seva from heart. Go on doing seva. Big seva. You try to understand the heart of pure Vaishnava. What is the exact heart of Guru Vaishnava? What they want to get? If you want to satisfy them, my Guruma used to clear this point, again used to feel sigh. My Guruma say, I am speaking this way, they can think, I am asking seva from them. Guruma is speaking. This point I am bound to clarify, but when I am speaking, somebody can think, the Maharaj when want to get some seva, that's why he is speaking this way. Pure Vaishnava, you should understand what kind of seva they want to do. If you can implement, that automatically you need not fight. Bharati Maharaj told me many times, Maharaj, you think I read so many books? Maharaj told me many times, I am sitting in Vyasasam. You don't think I read so many books? I only heard from Guru Bhargava and doing seva. This way I develop power. Maharaj told me. But that time I was doing seva whole day and night, no time to read books. But still I am getting power. So Siddhanta developed inside heart. All Guru Varga, I am doing seva. Bhakti Vigyan Bhakti Maharaj is doing seva so powerfully. You cannot understand. In Kumbh Mela, you see, sometime Allahabad here, there, some Kumbh Mela arrangement done. There, Bhakti Vijay Jadavar Goswami Maharaj, Adi, so nice devotee. They want to go and participate there. They wrote letter. But it was already last moment. Kumbh Mela already started, Maharaj like to go. Letter came. All devotees, they become angry. Eh? Maharaj lie coming last time. Where is place to stay? They are speaking this way. Then Bhakti began Bhardhima saying, your space is there. My space is there. My space is there. I can allow him to stay here. I can stay outside. No problem. You can stay. So much tolerance with Bhakti began Bharati Maharaj. Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha was so much tolerance. Because they know, if Guru Varga are coming, I have the scope to serve them. Come on. What I can do? Hey? In Kumbh Mela? Foolish idiot. Only fighting with Pratishtha place and facility. Always you should love each other. Try to ignore some small point. Ignore. A small point. That is called Bengali Kutinati. In Bengali Kutinati. Small point. You should ignore. If you catch, then your heart become very complicated. Dirty. Ah. Negative point is there, but still you should think positive way. I can discuss this point next Harikatha, Ekadashite. What Sati Devi is speaking, how, you know, I can speak. Then you can understand how to develop Vaishnava etiquette, how to become big Vaishnava. Otherwise, big problem. I like to see you all in combined, you know, so much doing, so clear, so neat and clean, I'm very happy. Want to cleanliness is next to godliness. In everywhere you can write. Cleanliness is next to anyway, one chakal madhura. I'm making joke.